another abandoned railway walk. Not out of a book this time. I found this one whilst waiting for an appointment in Tewkesbury. It started off as a tramway between Ashchurch, which was the main line, into the centre of Tewkesbury. It was then made into a steam line in 1844. In 1864, it was then extended from Ashchurch all the way through Tewkesbury, up to Severn to Malvern. And then in 1952, it all started to come apart at the seams. And in 1964, it was all lifted. Let's have a quick look at the map. See the line there runs north-south, Birmingham, Worcester, London. And then this is the line that we're following, which is the disused line, which goes into the centre of Tewkesbury. But there branches off, and that branch there then heads up into Malvern, up to Severn. And let's see what we can go and find. Ashchurch Station. On the branch line for Tewkesbury, turned off where you see the car park. Ashchurch then, in 1949, from this very bridge. Main line, north-south. Evesham, that way. Malvern, that way. Somewhat unappealing sight of the water tower, and this here would have been the goods marshalling area. Complete with an engine shed, no doubt. Extensive goods in that direction as well. The branch line there, just going off to the left, goes to Ashchurch Army. As you can see, it was once a twin track in the good old days. Might have been wartime use, of course. And the branch to Tewkesbury actually went through here to the right. It left the main line where you see the bus stop. Then wandered up there to Tewkesbury. Here the line's been made into rather a good metalled footpath. Over a nice railway culvert. The railway being on an embankment because this is all floodplain here. The path goes over a road bridge at this point, and some good old railway engineering has gone into building it. 2 miles from Ashchurch gets us to here, which is a very important part by the side of this thing. The line here carries straight on into the centre of Tewkesbury, but it also divides that way and heads for Malvern up to Severn. Or the other way around. And here is that branch line, looking towards Ashchurch, Malvern and Upton on Severn. The significance of this area is that this is where the Tewkesbury station was located. And that, I'm guessing, is the foundations of the signal box. Perhaps the rods and cables went out through that opening there. And almost certainly, this large gap here, starting with that stone, and going all the way along to there, would have been where the rods for the points exited the signal box. Old pair of rail supports built into the wall. Some old telegraph or electric pole stays. Before we head off for Malvern, let's go and have a look at the branch into the centre of Tewkesbury. Now the track is part road, part footpath, but if you look carefully, very carefully, you can still find evidence. Part of a low wall with the engineering blue brick. An old fence post at the side of the track. It's a while since any hinges hung on there. Still the remains of a catch though. You could easily miss that, couldn't you, by the side of the road. A railway sleeper post.
hidden amongst the trees, and attempted a railway picket fence, or it might actually be a railway picket fence, a substantial wall in the hedge, topped with rather finely engineered coping stones. The line continuing down there past what, judging by the scale, could have been a warehouse. Blue coping stones on an old fashioned sized brick wall. Another clue. Eventually the line ended up here, which is where they had sidings, a livestock market. But there was a tramway which went down here. Across here, which is the main drag, down here. And arrived here, the old flour mills. It would have brought in raw materials and taken out flour, one assumes. The old administrative blocks, offices and the like. And there's also a dock area here for transshipment of general goods.
Well, give this a shot. It might get complicated because there's all sorts of markings on this map. Ashchurch to bottom right. You can see the railway comes along. We've just passed the branch which takes you directly into Tewkesbury. And now we're heading northwest on up here. We come to next is Ripple station there, and north of Ripple jumps across the Severn, heading for Upton-on-Severn, and then out of Upton-on-Severn it then heads off westerly across the fields and the meadows, heading for the hills, and then eventually turns north again and joins the main line, actually in Malvern, just about there.
Now we'll follow the branch line then, heading towards Malvern and Upton-on-Severn. Hidden in there, some long forgotten structural support. Where, surprisingly, the track opens out. Welcome to Tewkesbury Station. Tewkesbury Station then. Raised on that side for the platform edge. And although we're on an embankment here, we're actually in a hollow between the two platforms. I'm reckoning that's a platform edge coping stone. Luckily there's no way to disprove it. And barely accessible here, off to the side, is a fenced off area, which I'm suggesting is the original station car park. Would have been full of Morris 8s, Morris 10s and the like. Well, I could get in there. I'm not sure I could get out again. The old access gates. How many vehicles drove through there? I bet he doesn't know he's sitting on history. Not because he cares either, to be honest. The track was singled for most of its length, so it would have been doubled through places like this to give a passing opportunity. Looking back, Tewkesbury Station. Almost unbelievable, isn't it, that there is the embankment when it was a running line. And that's the same one we're on now. And the reason we're on an embankment isn't just to do with this being a flood liable area. It's because we have to get across the River Avon. It's gaining some serious height now, as you can see, like the line above the cars. Before spanning the Avon, it has to cross the Rain Road.
And in this slightly poorer picture, you can actually see the bridge over the main road, even when it's intact. The gasometer is the same one that was in the previous picture. And the railway line now heads over the Avon.
Don't know what that did for a living. But on the opposite side of the road, there's nothing. All completely gone. Completely flattened by the marina company. It's searched for more land, although if you look very, very carefully through the barbed wire and over the boats, you can just see a railway bridge. Just see part of the structure, or a slightly better shot, new engineering brick, a trellis span and then more engineering brick. I think the plain brick has been put up as a guard.
And this is where it leaves Tewkesbury. Marina over there, and then the embankment.
Until very recently, this embankment used to carry on here across the fields, and then they removed it in order to alleviate some of the flooding, or hope to. There you've got the alignment of the old track here and the embankment over there. The second fence line shows you the line of the railway as it went across this floodplain and then disappeared over there on its way to Malvern. Where it shot into that, a tunnel. Then after 480 yards it pops out through here. And heads in that direction. Over the snowdrops and off down there. That's the bit we're interested in. Excavated 1861. And there we have it, beautiful line. Now disused. Finally, one of those trackside, a railway sleeper post. That's where the chair would have rested. And as you can see in the railway tradition, not barbed wire, plain wire. although it's on a rather tall embankment just of here, it is actually trying to seek out a way of getting across the River Severn. Which it achieved just of here, which is just above Ripple. You can see the railway embankment continues on the other side of the river. Just across the river you can see the spires in the buildings of Upton on Severn. Next stop, and then Malvern. The main pier on the Ripple Tewkesbury side. I thought they'd actually built the water monitoring station on one of the old piers. I think they probably used the foundation. I believe it used to have a swinging element so that ships with masts could get through. This is a picture of the line actually crossing the Severn. There's an engine there with a carriage and the Malvern Hills, top left. Entertainment courtesy of the British taxpayer. A little way back towards Tewkesbury, very conveniently, is this. This enables you to see the line of the railway. It's been totally grubbed out now, goes along there, turns around, and that's where we've just come from. That's where it jumps the Severn. Whilst looking the other way, you can see its last stop before crossing the Severn, which is Ripple. Looks like the locals put the sleepers to good use when the railway closed, as well as the rolling stock. A pretty village. There's a pretty strong clue on its way to crossing the Severn. After calling it Ripple Station. And just in there, the platform edge. The station in 1958, and there in the distance is the road bridge we just came off. Complete with old kissing gate, pedestrian entrance. And here, right on cue, because my tongue's hanging out. Perfect, perfect, right. One word. Very pretty, but I think we're supposed to be looking at a railway. This is seen from the Upton side, with the embankment just about visible through the trees, but not really accessible. And of Upton station?
Well, that's it.
One wall, giving way to a modern wall, and the fire station. And that's the location of Upton-on-Severn railway station. the station in 1912, looking towards Tewksbury.
From there it crossed the main road on a bridge and then went across there on an embankment, which has been cleared away to make a sports pitch that you can just see the remnants of in the distance. There, let's go take a look.
It's now conveniently got steps to the top. You'll have to think this was probably built as an accommodation bridge in the day, would have gone through there. Then from the top of the embankment, looking back towards the site of the station and the church there, Upton on your left, came from that direction, and then heads along the top of the embankment to Malvern. Bit of clear felling going on. Fallen soldier.
The Malvern Hills and our objective now hove into view from the top of what is a now defunct embankment. And the line rising all the time reaches here. And having crossed the main road, it then joins the main railway line there, just before the station. Bit of broad gauge rail acting as fence post here, showing its vintage alongside the modern rail. An old accommodation bridge. Obviously hadn't invented tractors when this was built. And it joined the main line about where the modern turn-in is. Just hit the man in the pretty coat. And finally, our destination, Malvern Station. What a beautiful little station. And there's the tunnel, which is a private entrance to the girls' school. Saves you getting your boater wet.